Hello everyone, welcome to the session. In this lecture, we'll solve a 10th question from the tutorial. So the question is, calculate the input referred thermal noise voltage of the amplifier shown in figure. The given figure is a common source amplifier. This is the given figure, where this is M1 and this is M2. This is Vout, Vin, and this is the bias voltage VB. So the question is to the first question is to find the input referred thermal noise voltage of the amplifier, and second part of the question is determine the total output thermal noise if the circuit drives a load capacitance, and the last part of the question is find the output SNR if the low frequency sinusoid of Vm is applied to the input. So basically there are three parts to this question. We'll try to solve one by one. So the very first part of the question is to calculate the input referred thermal noise voltage of the amplifier. So far, even in the lectures, we did not discuss about input referred thermal noise. So this is one form of representation representing thermal noise or noise voltage of an amplifier. So as of now, we know that the noise voltage of the circuit can be expressed at the output as VN out square bar. This is the way. So if I consider the noise sources in the circuit, I can write the output thermal noise voltage as VN out square bar. Now, since the question is to refer this noise voltage to the input, the method is, so I'll represent that as VN square bar, referring back at the input. So I'll use this notation, and that can be written as the output noise voltage divided by gain square, AV square of the circuit. So the idea is, if you have an amplifier block with a gain A, I can write output noise voltage as VN out square bar. If I want to refer back this input, refer back this output noise to the input side, simply divide that quantity by gain square. So that will give you input referred noise. Now, how to write this input referred noise for this particular circuit? Directly we can write the gain of the circuit AV. Gain of the circuit can be written as minus GM1 into R01 parallel to R02. So I am assuming transistors with lambda not equal to 0. Now, how to write VN out square bar? So that is your output thermal noise voltage. So to write output thermal noise voltage, I should consider the noise sources in the circuit. So if you see, there are two transistors are there, both have thermal noise component. So this thermal noise component I can express as IN square bar, but it is IN 2 square bar, and again for this also thermal noise component is IN 1 square bar. So these are the two noise sources. So if I want to write output noise voltage, I can always write it as the output current component. Output current component is the IN out square bar multiplied by R out square, where R out square, R out is R out 1, R not 1 parallel to R not 2. Now, what is IN out square bar? So these are the noise sources of two transistors in saturation. It is IN 2 square plus IN 1 square. Both are uncorrelated, so we can add their values, and the values are for this one, we know it is 8 by 3 KT GM1 plus again 8 by 3 KT GM2. Or we can write it as 8 by 3 KT into GM1 plus GM2. So if I write VN out square bar, or output thermal noise voltage. So I'll just write the terms. This is actually output thermal noise voltage. Again, it is mean square value, output thermal noise voltage. And this is actually a, this is an input referred. VN out square bar can be written as this value, 8 by 3 KT into GM1 plus GM2 multiplied by R01 parallel to R02 the whole square. This is your output referred, sorry, output thermal noise voltage. Right. So now we can write the input referred thermal noise voltage is equal to the output value divided by gain square. So it will be equal to 8 by 3 KT into GM1 plus GM2 multiplied by R01 plus R02 the whole. It is basically 3 divided by 2 square. So we will get a GM1 square term here, or it is 8 by 3 KT into 1 by GM1 plus GM2 by GM1 square. So this is your input referred thermal noise. So this is obtained after finding out the output thermal noise voltage. Now if you look at the second part of the question, it is to determine the total output thermal noise. And whenever the question is total output thermal noise, we should find the thermal noise and we should integrate that over the entire frequency. Then only we'll get the total output thermal noise. Now, but here there is a small difference. I should consider a load capacitance CL at the output point. So there is only one difference here. You need to, the first thing is to find VN out square bar. You should find VN out square bar. Then that quantity, so first is to find VN out square bar, then integrate that for 0 to infinity. And the third thing is you should consider capacitive load CL also. So these are the so this is actually, I can write this as the B part of the question, and this is actually A part. So this is A is done, and this is actually B part. Now here, first we will write what is R out. Now R out is R01 parallel to R02 parallel to a capacitance which is 1 by SCL. So that is first we should write. Now so for simplicity, or for like for for the calculation easiness, what I can write is I can write this R01 parallel R02 as some R0. So your R out can be written as R0 parallel 1 by SCL. Now since it is output resistance, I am interested only in the magnitude. So if I do this calculation separately, you will get this as R0 by 1 plus SR0 CL. Or if I write the magnitude of this, it is R0 by, so this case magnitude as R0 by under root of 1 plus omega naught, this 1 plus 2 pi, anything you can write. It is basically, it is 1 plus omega R0 CL the whole square. This is the magnitude term. Right. So now if I write VN out square, the value is same. It is 8 by 3 KT into, it is not input referred, it is output. So 8 by 3 KT into GM1 plus GM2 into, so the same formula. Your VN out square is 8 by 3 KT into GM1 plus GM2. Now in place of R01 parallel R02, you have R01 parallel R02 parallel 1 by SCL, or the magnitude term, and it is square, magnitude square. So now this is multiplied by R0 divided by 1 plus, it is R0 square by 1 plus omega R0 CL the whole square. This is actually your VN out square. Now the question is total output thermal noise. So to find total output thermal noise, what we can do is it is equal to the same value, but you should integrate over the entire range of frequency. So it is 8 by 3 kT gm1 plus gm2 into r0 square integral 0 to infinity 1 by 1 plus, you can write it as 2 pi f r0 cl the whole square. So what you can do here is you can assume the value of a as 1 by 2 pi r0 cl, and you can do this integration, which will be the form of a square by a square plus f square. You can take a square outside and you can apply the integration value, and you will finally get the result as 1 by 4 r0 cl. Now you can substitute this back to this equation. Yeah, so the total output thermal noise is 8 by 3 kT gm1 plus gm2 the whole square into r0 square into the value which we got from this integration. So it is this will be simplified as 2 by 3 kT by cl into gm1 plus gm2 into r0 is actually r01 parallel r02. So this will be the total output thermal noise. Now the third part of the question is find the output SNR if a low frequency sinusoid of amplitude Vm is applied at the input. So to find SNR, now we have noise power. So if you can write the signal power, that ratio will give you output SNR. So that is output SNR. To write the output signal power, the amplitude input amplitude is given as Vm. So Vm by root 2 is the RMS value, that multiplied by gain of the circuit. It is Gm1 into R01 parallel R02. No need to consider the capacitance, since it is given that the input signal is a low frequency sinusoid. And the power is actually the square of this, and noise power is actually we have here. Now, so SNR can be written as, consider this as equation number 1, sorry 2, and this as equation number 1. So for SNR you do 1 by 2. So now if you simplify, you will get the result as 3 by 4. CL will go to the numerator, CL by KT. It is gm1 square on the numerator, 1 r01 will be cancelled, so another r01 parallel r02 into vm square will be there on the numerator, divided by gm1 plus gm2. So this is the output signal to noise ratio. So the question, so these are the three questions what we had. Input referred thermal noise voltage. So after writing the output thermal noise voltage, divided by gain square will give you input referred thermal noise voltage. And we have seen how to calculate output thermal noise voltage. Second part is to calculate output thermal noise voltage if the circuit drives a load capacitance. So that also we have seen by considering 1 by SCL in parallel. And to find the total output thermal noise, you should integrate to the entire range of frequency from 0 to infinity. That gives the output thermal noise. And third part, to find output SNR, output signal power by noise power. So signal output signal power is amplitude, RMS value of the output amplitude multiplied by gain, the whole square is the power. And noise power is already there. So that will give you this fraction. So carefully listen and try to solve this question. If you have any doubts, you please ask and clarify. Thank you.